Hi guys, I'm so happy to be back. Whoa, I had a tough 2 days looking through all my videos. And as you may have noticed, the numbers are a little bit mixed up now because I had to adjust a couple of videos, and when you put them back on, they are placed in another, placed in another order, so. But if you subscribe to my channel, you can click on all videos, and then you can just, as usual, just look at the numbers, and the numbers are exactly how I made the videos, so no problem at all. From today on, there's going to be no more mix-ups with the videos, because it's not going to happen anymore, so. You can just, if you've seen all my videos, you just go on from yesterday, number 59, and today I'll make number 60, so we're going on from there. Again, I want to really express my appreciation for the people that are donating towards my channel, and everyone that's watching. These people make it possible that I do all these experiments, and I'd like to just thank them again. I know it's not a little thing to do. You have to look me up, you have to figure out how to donate, and then you give your hard-earned money to me. So that's very, very much appreciated. Like I said yesterday, I bought a lot of stuff from the donation money. I bought Flutrol. This is something that a lot of people have asked me about, and I haven't used it yet, so today is going to be the day. And I have bought a lot of tools, like these things, you know what they are. But I was going to see if I could do some serious swiping with one of these, because I want to do something, you know, just in one motion. One swipe up, and then I hope for something magical to happen. So I bought that one. And in case the plastic didn't work, I bought a metal one. And I have bought these rubber squeegee things, because there's another thing I want to get into. Someone sent me a link to an artist who does amazing things with just pouring acrylic paint on a surface, and then putting other colors on top, and then with that squeegee thing doing stuff with it. But I'm not going to be practicing online, because I want to do that offline. So these are the last two I did on the monochrome, and they worked out beautifully. I really like the green one. This one is already sold. This one is still for sale. I'm just waiting a couple more days for it to dry fully, and then I'm going to be putting a varnish on it, and I'll contact the lady who said she wanted to buy it. So this one's still for sale, green one's gone. So that's that. Then still I have my first painting sold, Don, Sylvie, and Angela. I think Sylvie has already received hers. Don and Angela, it might still take a couple of days. Okay, then I think I've had all the stuff I wanted to talk to you about. What I'm going to be doing in this video is I want to pour on a record. So here is the record, which I want to pour on. And for the Dutch viewers, this is Rob de Nijs. He made some nice songs. And this was even autographed, signed by him. But, you know, I'm going to pour on this. I can't, you know, buy all these records and then think, hey, let's keep it because it's a collector's item. I don't even have one of those things you put this on. So I'm pouring on this one. I put a little sticky tape on the back. And because I want to keep this whole, because I'm going to make this into a fruit bowl. After it's totally dry, I'm going to pop it in the oven, and then, you know, if you put it on some sort of a can, just imagine this being a lower and a bigger can, then you put it on like that, you put it in the oven, And the warmth just makes it warp down on all sides. It goes down. So then when you turn it, these sides come up and you have a really cute fruit bowl. And I think a lot of people would like to see me do that, because you see them on YouTube all the time, but I don't think they really show you how to do it and the temperature and what you have to watch out for. So that's why I'm going to be doing that and show you guys how to do it, and put in the information the temperature of the oven. I'm going to first Google that, because I think it's a very low temperature. I'm so happy that I'm back painting. I can't even tell you, because I haven't painted for 2 days, and it's really addicting. And I was thinking, oh, let me finish these stupid videos because I want to paint. So I'm so glad I can paint today. I'll be making a couple of videos. I just mixed 14 colors paint. So, and that's not even paint for the Floutrol, because Floutrol doesn't need a painting medium. So all those colors are going to go into the pours I'm going to do today. I am going to make a new one, the giveaway one. I'm going to make a new one today. I'll show you guys. You know, the funny thing is that someone wrote to me on YouTube. They commented, they said, you know, it is so beautiful. It reminds me of the sea. And it reminds me of the sea too. And then I looked at it with different eyes, and I saw the beauty in it. You know, how the white is like the sea foam. And I said that before, but now when I just look at it with different eyes, because someone mentioned how beautiful they thought it was. So I'm going to try to make a new one today. I already got the paint mixed. What I'm really waiting for is the, I ordered some museum canvas, some museum quality, and that's what I'm sort of waiting for, because I'd like to pour it on some more expensive canvases. Okay, so that's about what we're going to do today. First the record, then I'm going to try to make another seascape 20 by 20, and I figured out all the shipping, that's all okay, so I'm happy about that. No more headaches about how I'm going to ship that stuff. If you buy one of these, the 20 by 20, I'm going to ask for $48.95. So if it's euros you're paying, it's 45 euros, and in dollars it's $48.95, and that's including shipping. So that's it, that's the total price. And I don't want to make it too expensive, because I'm not yet very well known. People are starting to buy stuff, and I'm getting a lot of emails that they want to buy paintings. But I don't think, I can put price tags on there. I don't know, for like $100. I think that's overdoing it. You got to stay humble in this profession. If you don't, you're not selling anything. So $48.95, including shipping, for a 20 by 20. And if people are interested in the 30 by 30s, I'll do that in the next video. I'll do the mathematics on it. And the shipping is 10 euros more on a 30 by 30. So that's 27, but I'll make a nice price. Okie dokie. So only one thing left for me to show you, the people that are really following my videos. That's this one. I did it yesterday with, on this side, the glossy, this side, the matte. And I left a stripe in between so you can see the difference. Don't know if it really shows up on camera, but you can see the shiny side here. Then you see here in the middle, there's nothing. And then on this side, that's the matte. And I am sort of more leaning towards the glossy. I like the glossy more than, but then I'm thinking, okay, but that's pretty shiny and this is pretty nice too. So both ways, this is great varnish, and it's for outside even, so it has a very good UV protection in it, and I'm pretty happy I bought it. Okie dokie. did another test on these. I showed you yesterday. This side, this is the glossy, that one is the matte, and they both look beautiful. I really can't say that one is better than the other in keeping the colors vibrant, because they both are vibrant. And remember, this is that very cheap acrylic paint bought at the dollar store. So it turned out very well. Put it up close a little bit so you can see the patterns. It's cute. Okay, so let's go. I'll put this aside because everyone knows, end of the month, I'll be cutting out all these names, putting them in a big hat, and then juggling it, blah, 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 and picking one out. I'm doing that online, and the video will be named March giveaway. That's it. I won't number it, just March giveaway, and I'll do that online. Because I want you guys to realize that I'm the real deal. I don't bullshit you. At the end of this video, I'll be showing you my solar panels, because yesterday I got two or three comments about my plastic cups. And by the way, I'm going to do the record on this spinny thing. I kind of like that. I'm going to put the record on here, like this, put a little sticky tape here. Then put it on. Oops, not centered very well, but I'll do that in a bit. And I'm going to be pouring on here. But there were some people that were concerned about the way I dispose of my plastic cups. I can promise you they do not get put in a landfill. They do not get put into the environment. I pay a lot of money for all my rubbish to get burned. In Holland, we separate our rubbish. You have paper, you have plastic, you have the green, everything that's green, like if you peel potatoes and all that kind of stuff, and everything out of your garden, your leaves and all that stuff, that goes in one. And then you have the overall bin. That overall bin, that costs like $6.50 every time they empty it for you. And it's not big. It's 2x2 and 4 high. And that costs €6.50 every time they take that to get burned. So it gets burned, there's filters in place. Everything is very, very environmentally friendly. Then I have all my solar panels. So that's saving the world a lot of CO2. And I'm very, very picky about meat, the meat I eat. I don't like eating meat, but when I do, I want it to have the seal of better life. We call it better life here in Holland. If you have that on there, it's a sort of a government seal. They take care that the meat that has the seal, the animals get a better life. So they are more outside and they have more room to live and all that kind of stuff. So I'm very conscious about buying anything that is meat or eggs or milk from animals that have had a better life. But I know not everyone can do that because it is more expensive. So I totally understand. Everyone can do what they want, but I just want to explain that no matter how much paint I'm throwing, I'm always thinking about the environment. So put your little mind at ease. I'm doing my best to do it as it should be. Ready to pour. What you need to do is get an old vinyl record like this. Then you have to clean this stuff off because they're old and you don't know if you buy them at the secondhand store. You don't know where those people have had those these vinyl things, if they smoked or if it's dirty or all that kind of stuff. So I'm going to be cleaning it right now. And for that I have alcohol. So just let's see how much dirt is on here. Nah, these were, this is a non-smoking household. these are clean. And they maybe have kept this, you know, as a sort of a collector's item too, because of the signature that was on here from this artist. Okay, it looks pretty squeaky clean to me. Maybe just one more with a little clean bit. But you know, you should be making sure that it's nice and clean, so that the paint can really stick on it. And I might be doing a second one. I'll gesso it first. I might be doing that, yeah. Because this one's going to be fruit bowl. Then I'm going to do one that I'm going to make a clock out of, because it has the hole in the middle. You can just put that clockwork right through. And then I want to do one just for hanging on the wall, and I'll show you how to hang one of these. So, that's clean. And now we have to choose the colors. Well, I was thinking about these colors. Very pretty, bright, and spring-like colors. That's about it. Can you see all the colors? Almost. So this is the colors I'm going to be using. That's it. It looks really nice, spring and springy, and makes me want to, I don't know, eat Easter eggs or something. Easter is coming up, and it would be nice to have this in more of this sort of a color. So I was thinking I'm going to spin it and then pour it. So start off with a little white. And a little yellow. Then on the opposite side, a little bit of green. But I'm putting it in very slowly because I'm spinning, so that's going to create a lot of motion. So I don't have to pour it up high from here, because it will be poured on there with a certain speed. And I'm guessing I need about a cup full. We've had some real bad weather the last couple of days. And I have a little cold. You can hear it in my voice. But today's a beautiful day. Solar panels are picking up a lot of sun. And some more white, because I really want a lot of white in this one. That would be nice. Then a little splash of orange again, along with the yellow. And then some more white. And I want some light green in there. And after this video, I'll be mixing another paint batch, because I'm already almost out of white. Okay, we're ready. This is the cup. So you saw me how I layered it all. In here is my silicone, because I'm going to be doing this in every video, guys. I know the most of you know this, but I keep getting questions. What does the silicone do? What is the brand? What is the torch? So I'm going to be doing this just in case someone new is watching. The silicone creates the cells when you heat it up. And there's pouring medium in here and a lot of acrylics from Amsterdam Acrylics. All these colors are Amsterdam Acrylics. Some colors I mixed, like the green. I didn't like all the light green, so I put a little bit of Prussian blue in there to darken it. So that worked out very well. So let's just do the pouring. What'll I do? So shall I really spin it fast? Clockwise, yeah. Ooh, I like that. Now I'm totally covered in paint. And I bet you guys are all laughing, laughing, laughing. Oh, she's covered in paint. But I love this. Look at that. Is that beautiful? Look at all those cells popping all by themselves. Just have to wash my hands. That's it. Oh, I think that is gorgeous, really. This is unreal. I love the colors. And I thought I'd get a lot of white, but the white is all underneath the colors. And I have to buy a new torch. My torch just broke. Because it's the thing that releases the gas is stuck. See, I can't put it on. I have to use another one to put it on. Okay. Let me see where I am going to torch. A little over here. I like that. Along the side. A little in the middle. Nah, I'm going to torch it all because I really like this one. Especially there. That is beautiful. Here a lot of lacing. Unreal. Okay, that's it. That's all I'm going to do. And it's still working because I can see the yellow coming up now. Oh, it's unreal. This is so beautiful. Gee, this is beautiful. Okay, what I need to do is put it up a little, I think, because it has a little bit of a slope and the paint is falling off a little bit. See, I'm going to be cleaning off the under it. There's a lot of paint under there. So I don't think I really needed 200 milliliters of paint. If you were to do this, I would do in 200, yeah, maybe 200, yeah. Go for 200. Yeah, it's better to have a little paint left over than not having enough. So I want to thank you all very much, guys, for supporting my channel, doing everything possible to keep me doing all these kind of things. Because look at this. Gee, that is beautiful. I'm going to show you up close. Then I'm going to show you my sun panels, solar panels. Okay, look at that. How beautiful is it? This is going to be such a pretty fruit bowl. Okay, imagine all the colorful fruit in there. The bananas and the Granny Smith apples. And then I want something orange like mandarins. It's going to be beautiful. I really like that bit. Can you see that? The pink right in the middle now. That is beautiful. And I like the swirly thing there. I love the whole thing. It's unbelievable. Look at the lacing here. Can even see the green popping through the lacing. That's beautiful. Okay, I'll show you my roof. Oh, a lot of sun outside. Can you see all the solar panels? And you see in the, you see my garden, but there's, look at that, there's not a leaf on the trees because it's so cold. But there are my solar panels, a lot of them. So don't worry about me. I promise I will be good to the environment. Now, thank you all for watching. Make some beautiful art. And see you in the next video. Bye-bye.